To talk about this development is Dr. Kathryn Radigan, a pulmonologist from Cook County Health. Good evening. Thanks for joining us.
Good evening. Thank you for having me.
So it turns out that steroids potentially could be effective in fighting COVID-19.
So I think that this information is clearly a press release, and I think that we really need to, in order to interpret it appropriately, we need to wait until the study is published. But I think this is important information, and it's promising.
Well, doctor, what is it about this steroid that makes it promising? What have they seen? What has it shown?
What we know is that coronavirus is quite an inflammatory disease. Steroids in general reduce inflammation within the body. And so what it's hopeful is that basically the steroid may be helpful for very severely ill patients in terms of improving their outcomes, in terms of decreasing the inflammation within the body. Now, what's important is that once the study is published, we need to weigh the benefits and risks of the treatment. So number one, what are the benefits in terms of reduced mortality and what particular patients they're using this dexamethasone in? And then also the complications of using steroids. As we know as physicians, is that steroids decrease the effectivity of the immune system. And so we need to ensure that we're giving the steroid in the correct situation for each individual patient.
As you mentioned, we do need to slow down and find out about the effectiveness. At what point will we see the peer review? How soon can that be completed?
I think that's up to the individual journal. So I think that we're all hopeful, but I think that we need to interpret this information with caution. We do use steroids in some particular patients with coronavirus currently, and I think it's important always for every physician to treat each individual patient as an individual and weigh the benefits and risks of each treatment, and also understand that steroids is just one component of the patient's entire treatment plan, and that these patients are extremely complex sick patients once they get into the intensive care unit, and that we ensure that we're doing absolutely everything we can in treating them and having the best outcome. And steroids may be just one component of this, but I think that we also need to always do no harm, proceed with caution, and treat each patient as an individual.
How does this compare to hydroxychloroquine or remdesivir as far as treating COVID-19 patients?
I don't know if you can accurately compare it. I think that this is still a drug that I have used in patients, that we still need a randomized controlled trial. That's what this trial would be. So that once we find out more information and see the actual trial published, what happens when a trial is published is that it's peer reviewed and that doctors can actually see what patient population they used it in and the kind of complications that may occur so that we can actually prevent complications from a particular intervention.
So still very early stages. Thank you, Dr. Radigan. We appreciate it. Be safe, be well.